Hey Kid Factory fans, well, it's Papa Smurf, and I believe this is update number 6 or 5, I don't know. It'll be specified in the title before I started babbling. Today's the 26th of May, and the 25th was my son's birthday, Carl. Happy birthday, brother. My son's an amazing guy, I love him very much. So today we're going to do this little extra to some of the Facebook posts that I did. As I said, now I'm kind of assembling several segments that I do in several places. The only thing I don't show you is my Patreon posts, because they are strictly for my members. In case that you would like to join my Patreon, because I can always use a little bit of cash boost, as in the fact that nowadays, you know, I'm on Social Security disability because of the old leg and several other problems that I have. I know, I'm freaking crazy. But, yeah, it's part of the problem. I'm not the only one, apparently. I wonder if y'all heard that. This is Daytona Beach. It's kind of crazy here. Cut.
Two hours later.
And they drove away, thankfully. So we're going to go over some of the stuff that I showed in these last few videos that you saw posted by now, I'm presuming. And we're going to show you where we're at now, which is the secondary hall, which has got to be the most complex section in this build. I first presumed it was the primary hall, which took a few weeks, but this is 3 or 4 weeks in. And this thing contains the arboretum and the shuttle bay, which I tend to go pretty much hog wild in, because it is a major showpiece, especially in the motion picture version, because it goes like all the way through the ship, literally just almost all the way above the arboretum when it's untouched. Now, in the version that I do, I have to cut it forward a little bit because I want access for the wiring, which is something I've either gone over already or I did in the former videos. And so the thrusters are installed here, the arboretum, the shuttle bay, and 95% of the lighting. The only thing I still have to do here is the blinker, the navigation detail up here, and the two spots that go shining above the pylon. These are below the pylon, and none of them are refined yet as far as projection goes. So what's left after this is the next section and the two pylons that lead up to the warp engines. And then we've got a primed, ready-to-go, ready-to-paint piece, which is, you know, some people like to pre-paint them before you assemble them. Of course, the problem is things don't always go together the way they're supposed to. And I have found that you most often ruin the paint work, especially if you're going to do all the Aztec and everything first. And they are hard to match up afterwards. So I prefer to paint it all in, a 3 or 4 layer application, all matched when the ship is already put together. It's trickier to mask and do, but in the end, it pays off greatly. So we're going to turn the lights off, and I'm going to show you some of the details I've done, as well as one last look before I close it up of all the interior lighting and whatever. This is about 4 weeks worth of work a month. And yes, that's what a month is. It's 4 weeks. One, two, three. The count. We don't have a Dracula character, but I guess Professor's close enough. So let's take a look at this. The previous videos have you set for this part. And so what you'll be probably seeing next as a video is when the saucer is attached through the neck, and we start getting pretty serious at that point. We've already got all our assembly and everything done. It's very strong, very rigid. So, and dig this old Star Trek chair, huh? Yeah, my wife gave me this. Pretty cool. So, let's take a look at what I got here, and then I'll compile a video of all this stuff that I've shown you so far, and we can move on. Okay. And I'll probably use a better camera for the close-ups, because this iPad tends not to be so good. Not on close-ups and in the dark. No. All right, moving on.
Let me see.
Alright, a little 3 a.m. action. This is the sensor dish, which is one of the, other than the top, last section, segments, sub-assemblies to go into the secondary hull. And we'll go ahead and power this up. And let's see, this is, remember, I have no switches or anything installed at this time. So, this will give us, first color is our amber, which is when you're in impulse mode. Now, one of the problems with a central LED to light up a larger area is that hot point in the center. Now what I've done, and this is still in development, kids, what I've done is I frosted the inside of the lens as well as soft sanding it. And inside, I have soft sanded a small piece of milky crystal plastic, or a milky plastic making up a crystal. And then the actual bulb inside has been shaved off at the top. Now, the further I recess it, the more dissipated the light becomes. But at a certain point, you will lose definition of the light. So, and if we go to the blue, let's see here. There we go. with the blue as well. So it's more like a twinkle in the center than this hard-edged, obvious LED lighting. See what I'm saying? It's very soft and fuzzy at the center, which is more believable as a light source than just, you know, a very hard-edged bulb sticking there. So that's it so far on this. We're still experimenting. I'm still trying to get it down some as far as the hardness factor. But when you have a parabolic dish and the LED is right there under the center, even if you dissipate it with the lenses like I have, you still end up with that a little bit. And to the eye, it's not quite that drastic. But with a camera, you do get a stronger focal point than you do when you're looking at it by eye. All right, that's it for now. Moving on. All right, now using a much better camera, the Canon XA11 or X11A. I'm not really sure, to be honest with you, but we'll move on here. So taking a look at what's been done, we can see that the Arboretum is now installed, very well installed, nicely behind actual glass. All the lighting in the side is on. And let's go ahead and turn off the lights here. Now you can see the thrusters in the front that I've installed. I went with a orangey color, sorry about that, because it's very evident, it's very stylish, and I thought that would look nice. There's a few bugs out tonight, so if you see some UFOs, that's what it is. Let me see here. So, doing a sweep across. Now, most of the work in the last few days has been around the shuttle bay area. And let's tilt that around. I may have to do some adjusting. Gonna be hitting the old mic here. Now, as you can see, the red details have been added. I'm trying to stay in focus here. Whenever you're dealing with something in a night setting, it can be a little difficult. There we go. Now you can kind of get the concept. As we look down the shuttle bay, it's very hard to keep things in focus in dark shots. Yeah, I think that's about as good as I can get without getting really freaky here. See what I'm saying? And it's trying real hard. It does a heck of a lot better. There we go. Than the iPad. The iPad's good all overall, but it doesn't specialize in anything. There we go. So now you can get a really good look at the red details towards the rear, which I'm still working on. Two of them are really not where I want them, but the blue details are really nice. The reds here, for some reason, I've been having trouble with this side, and I may have to drill back through it and start over again. I do not know why that happened, but when you're dealing with resin, sometimes things go wrong, and that definitely seems to be the case. Nothing a Dremel can't handle. Now, in the front, let's see, as we go around, there's your sensor dish array, which has finally been installed. Now, in one of the prior videos, you saw what I was capable of doing and doing from blue to amber, but that whole thing's been put in and installed. But you can see now that the thruster arrangement
four points has been installed. And those, once hooked into the circuit, will be able to turn on and off intermittently as if adjusting trajectory. This is something I've put into, I think, to every refit I've ever done. And it's just a fun feature. And just to see one of those yellow little guys pop up once in a while is a fun option. That's all it is. It's just interesting. So there you have it. And again, you've seen it from the top. You've seen all the special effects there are. And it'll keep getting more interesting. We're getting close to attaching the neck on this section, the top section, getting all the wiring through of the warp engines going down, and then actually building those warp engines, which is our last segment. And then we're on our way to painting. Always remember that even though you've gotten this much done, you are technically only about halfway done, or slightly better, because the painting and lighting aspect are two separate entities. Anyways, I'll wrap this up, and I hope this camera gave you a slightly better look at what we've done so far. And we're about, I don't know, just short of 2 months into it. I know the painting can take over a month. It's that much work, kids. Later, Papa out.
Mission.
Otto!
Otto is Hans's brother. Yes. I think. Whole thing feels kind of weird.
Anyways, Otto, yes. Guide the Blitz 10 towards the target zone. It's been marked on your radar screen. Yes. Watch out for that little final. Oh, yeah. When this baby seal. Yes, as soon as we get the ALB little Yeti's campsite, I will denote the darns for you, Otto. Otto, what? Oh! Well, okie dokie here. A baby smell. Not today. No, I remember. That much I remember. Alright, advance! Oh, here we go. Ah, Otto! Look at there. Hello, Mr. Yeti. Remember me?
Oh,
Jeez! That's what's up now! Yeah! Alright, Otto, turn around! That's a good boy. Alright! Get out of this thing, Auntie! Yeah, oh, no, I don't need no surrender today. Otto, darn it, Auntie. Little white monkey. Ah. All right, I'll head back for the helicopter lift point. We are going home to, some Smurfs have an appointment. Yes, yes, let's head back. I've got some plans for them.
Let's see. This is a pretty good vantage point. Let's see, the alignment's pretty good. Well, it's a really good day to do this. Smurf War 5, it's not going to be a big deal. I didn't advertise it or anything. It's the bicentennial Smurf Congress. Every Smurf in the world is right down there in Smurf City. And, you know, every Smurf. You know, in the old days, you didn't have the kind of... Stop it. Let's see. Anything in acquisition? Oh, we got a lock! There it is, alright.
What's it just that? We didn't find it, right?
As currency, yes, yes, and what else? We will now have a 3-hour work week, and everyone must drink heavily every day. Let's see what else.
Mountain of marshmallows.
Professor, quit dazing off, man. You got more work to do up front.
Yes, I looked at it off. Oh, man, it wasn't real. It was just a dream. Oh, you bastard.